Hello children, welcome to everybody. This is Jayanta sir of St. Vincent Convent Senior Secondary School, Balasore. Today I am going to teach Mathematics of Standard 8 and the chapter name is Rational Number. We will do that exercise 1B and we will learn today that how to do that subtraction of rational numbers. First question is that subtract 3 by 4. From 5 by 6. From 5 by 6 means we are going to write that first 5 by 6. Subtract means minus 3 by 4. So 6 and 4 LCM is coming that 12. 12 divided by 6 equal to 2. 2 into 5, 10. Minus, minus. 12 divided by 4. 4, 3 are 12. 3 into 3, 9. So 10 minus 9 equal to 1 by 12. Again another example, subtract minus 5 by 8 from minus 7 by 12. Which one is given that from minus 7 by 12 we are going to write that first this one, minus 7 by 12. Subtract means minus. How much it is? Minus 5 by 8, minus 5 by 8. Now equal to minus 7 by 12, minus 7 by 12 you write down, minus into minus it is plus. 5 by 8, 5 by 8. Now LCM of 12 and 8 is coming the 24. 24 divided by 12. 12 to the 24. 2 into minus 7 equal to minus 14. Then plus, plus. Then 24 divided by 8. 8, 3 the 24. 3 into 5, 15. Now minus 14 plus 15 equal to 1 by 24. Children, you open your book. That example 6, the sum of two rational number is minus 5 by 8. If one of these numbers is minus 7 by 12, find the other one. Children, try to understand that. Here question is given that sum of any two numbers, two rational number is minus 5 by 8 and one of them is minus 7 by 12, find the other rational number. So we'll write now that answer, the sum of two rational number equal to minus 5 by 8 as it is given in the question. One of the numbers equal to minus 7 by 12, one of the number equal to minus 7 by 12, the other rational number equal to minus 5 by 8 minus minus 7 by 12. Children, why we did here, try to understand that. If question is given that sum of two numbers equal to 10 and one of them is given that 6, what is the other one? That means 10 minus 6 equal to, as you are getting 4, then 6 plus 4 equal to 10. Like that here, that sum of that two rational number is given and one number is given. So we are doing that, this one sum of two rational number minus one number we are doing. So now come here that minus into minus plus we did. Now 8 and 12 LCM is coming there, 24. 24 divided by 8, 8, 3 is at 24. 3 into minus 5, minus 15, plus, plus. 24 divided by 12, 2, 2 into 7 equal to 14. Now minus 15 plus 14 equal to minus 1 by 24. Now come to that next example, children. Example 7. What should be added to minus 3 by 8 to get 5 by 6? What should be added with 2 minus 3 by 8? So we are taking that, let x be added to minus 3 by 8 to get 5 by 6. Then we can write now that x be added to how much? Minus 3 by 8. So we can write now that minus 3 by 8 plus x equal to 5 by 6. Imply that x equal to 5 by 6 minus minus sign minus 3 by 8 coming this side, changing means plus 3 by 8. Now 6 and 8 LCM is coming there, 24. 24 divided by 6 equal to 4. 4 into 5, 20. Then plus sign rod. Now 24 divided by 8 equal to 3. 3 into 3 equal to 9 we got. Then equal to 20 plus 9 equal to 29 by 24, and converting into the mixed fraction 1 all 5 by 24. Now come to that next example in your book itself. What should be subtracted from minus 3 by 8 to get 5 by 6? Let x should be subtracted from minus 3 by 8 to get 5 by 6. Let x be subtracted. Let x be subtracted from minus 3 by 8 to get 5 by 6. So according to question, x be subtracted from minus 3 by 8. So my from means this one, minus 3 by 8. Subtracted means minus x equal to get, that is given, to get 5 by 6. Now come here that minus x equal to 5 by 6, it was 5 by 6, my minus sign coming, this sign means it will be plus 3 by 8, imply that minus x equal to 6 and 8 LCM is coming, that 24 divided by 6, 4 into 5 20 plus 8 3 are 24, 3 into 3 9, imply that minus x equal to 20 plus 9 equal to 29 by 24. Imply that minus x coming this side means it will be minus 29, minus x, it is coming minus 29. So x value got that minus 29 by 24. So what should be subtracted? Therefore, minus 29 by 24 should be subtracted from minus 3 by 8 to get 5 by 6. Children, next come. Here that to learn that properties of subtraction of rational numbers. Closer property. If A by B and C by D are two rational numbers, then subtraction of these two rational numbers, whatever value we are getting, suppose we are getting that E by F, that rational number. So it is also a rational number. Suppose we are getting that E by F after subtracting these two, then this is also a rational number. Like that, as we had learned that in previous class, closer property of addition of a rational number, A by B plus C by D equal to E by F is also a rational number. In case of subtraction also, after subtracting, whatever value you are getting, that is also a rational number. Now come to that commutativity. The subtraction of rational number is not commutative, but in case of addition, it is commutative. So look at here, if A by B and C by D are two rational numbers, then A by B minus C by D is not equal to C by D minus A by B. In case of addition, it was equal, but in case of subtraction, this is not equal. Now come to that associativity. The subtraction of rational numbers is not associativity. For example, that if A by B, C by D and E by F are three rational numbers, then in case of associativity, we can write that A by B minus C by D minus E by F is not equal to A by B minus C by D minus E by F. Children, you observe here that last 2 it is given bracket, and here it is first 2 it is given bracket, and this is not equal to. In case of subtraction, it is not equal to, but in case of addition, this is equal. Associativity of rational number is always associativity, means it is equal. Now come to that next property, existence of identity for a rational number A by B. If it is A by B minus 0 equal to same value, it is A by B. But 0 minus A by B equal to minus A by B. So therefore, A by B is not equal to minus A by B. Did you understand here? Observe here that 0 minus A by B equal to minus A by B. Here A by B you got, here you got that minus A by B. So A by B is not equal to minus A by B. Now come to that existence of inverse. Inverse of subtraction does not exist. Now come to that example of exercise 1B, question number 7. Which rational number should be added to minus 5 by 9 to get minus 2 by 3? Let x be added to minus 5 by 9 to get minus 2 by 3. X be added to minus 5 by 9. So minus 5 by 9, what should be added? X be added. How much to get? Minus 2 by 3. According to the question, it is written here. Imply that x equal to minus 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3 rod. But minus 5 by 9, when side changing, it is coming that plus 5 by 9. Equal to 3 and 9 LCM is coming that 18. 18 divided by 3, 6. 6 2 is 12, minus 12. Then plus. 18 divided by 9, 9 2 is 18. 2 into 5, it is 10. So minus 12 plus 10. Equal to minus 2 by 18. Now you children reduce the 2 table. 2 9 is 18, then 2 1 is 2. So we got the result that minus 1 by 9. Therefore, minus 1 by 9 should be added to minus 5 by 9 to get minus 2 by 3. Next children, come to that question number 8 in exercise 1B. Which rational number should be subtracted from minus 5 by 6 to get 4 by 9? Like that also you can take here. Let x be subtracted from minus 5 by 6 to get 4 by 9. Once again, let x be subtracted from minus 5 by 6 to get 4 by 9. So accordingly we wrote that minus 5 by 9. What should be subtracted? X should be subtracted to get 4 by 9 we wrote. Now minus x equal to 4 by 9, then 4 by 9 we wrote. Then minus 5 by 6, side changing means it is plus 5 by 6. Imply that minus x equal to LCM 9 and 6 coming that 18. 9 to 18, 2 into 4, 8 plus 6 to 6, 3 is 18, 3 into 5, 15. Imply that minus x equal to 8 plus 5, 23 by 18. And minus x, it is coming this side, means it is coming that minus 23 by 18. Therefore, minus 23 by 18 should be subtracted from minus 5 by 6 to get 4 by 9. Children, next come to that question number 10, beat third eye. Evaluate. Question number 10, it is given that evaluate, and question is given that 4 by 7 minus 8 by 9, then minus 13 by 7 plus 17 by 9. So we can do also 4 by 7 minus into minus plus 8 by 9, then minus into minus, that is plus 13 by 7, then plus 17 by 9. Then 7, 9, 7, 9. That means 7 and 9 LCM is coming that 63. 63 divided by 7. 7, 9 is 63. 9 into 4, 36. Then plus sign. 63 divided by 9. 9, 7, 7, 8 is 56. Then plus. 63 divided by 7, 9. 9 into 13, 117. Then plus. Then 63 divided by 9. It is 7. 7 into 17 equal to 119. Now adding all these things, we are getting that 328 by 63. And after dividing, converting into the mixed fraction, we got that 5/13 by 63. Children, or this one can be done also this way also. That question number 10. Bit third eye can be done also this way also. Look at here. 4 by 7 minus 13 by 7. Observe here that all the denominators making that equal. 7, all the denominators same, bringing 1. Plus 9, 17 by 9 minus 8 by 9. So 9 is here. Now come here that 4 by 7 minus into minus plus 13 by 7 plus 17 by 9 minus into minus, it is plus 8 by 9. Now look at here that 4 plus the denominator is same, 7. So we wrote that 7. Then 4 plus 13. Then plus. Denominator is 9. So 9 wrote. Then 17 plus 8. Now coming that 4 plus 13, 17 plus plus, then 17 plus 8, 25, then equal to 7 and 9, LCM is coming that 63. 63 means 7, 9, that 63, 9 into 17, 153 plus plus. Then 63 divided by 9, 7, 7 into 25. 7 into 25, 175. Now 153 plus 175, total coming that 328 divided by 63, and converting into that mixed fraction, it is coming that 5 whole 13 by 63. Children, for you that homework exercise 1B you will be doing, and if you are finding any difficulty, you keep for me after reopening the school, we'll solve that one. Children, thank you. See you again in the next class.